The purpose of this teaching video is to walk you into a resource by the name of Arcade. Arcade is located inside
makecode.org or makecode.com.
Either one of them will direct you to this website.
If you want to save any of your work, my recommendation is to come over here where it says sign in. Here in Clovis Unified, all of our students will use the same login starter as they would use to get into the computer. So if your name is Mickey Mouse and your username is Mickey Mouse 001, that's the standard starting point that you would use.
You also need to use the at symbol followed by my.cusd.com. As long as you have made no mistakes in your email at all, it will take you straight into your account. If you have any error messages on the screen, erase your email and then start again.
You'll know that you're signed in when your name appears over here in the right-hand corner. From there, you can head over to the resource that you used last, and your hard work should be saved for you so you can pick up where you left off.
Inside the Arcade tool, there are many ready-to-go resources that will showcase, highlight, and help you understand elementary coding strategies. You can search through and find a game or an idea that is interesting to you. And your hard work may or may not be saved. If you are signed into the Microsoft tool, it will save your hard work. So these are resources that I've worked on before. Or you can start from scratch and then just use a brand new project. In today's lesson, I'm going to choose Chase the Pizza under tutorials. And you'll notice that each of these have different categories as you slide down. So JavaScript, community games, game design concepts, and over here on the far right, you'll notice that there is an arrow command that will bring you into more or additional resources. So let me choose Chase the Pizza. I'm going to click on this one time. Down here at the bottom, it says start the tutorial. It gives you a little highlight window indicating the objective or the purpose of this game. If you change your mind and you don't want to go in, there's a small X over here. I'm going to click on start tutorial. When you start the tutorial, it will explain to you what is expected of you. So if you read through these ideas, it's going to give you vocabulary, concepts, and objectives. Right here it says two sprites. Whenever you have something actively moving on your screen, the vocabulary that is used is sprites. And then one of the objectives is that the sprite is supposed to move over to the food. So item number one and item number two on the screen, sprite number one and sprite number two. So I'm going to click OK. A tutorial will appear up at the top telling you exactly what to do. And then along the top, it shows you your achievement. Item number one introduced you to the purpose of the game. Item number two, you're actually making decisions. And then item number three, you're manipulating and making more decisions and so on.
In this space, you have six main areas. Your progress bar along the top, followed by the instructions in this space, down below, is the place where you drop all of your code. It's called your workspace. Over to the left, you have the toolbox. On the far left, you have the game space so that you can see what your code would actually make the game do. And then down here on the bottom left, I have this little toolbar that's kind of in the way, but that's the download area. So if you actually have a Meowbit gaming device, you would use the download button in order to export that information so that you can actually play the game in your hand.
Up here it says open the scene toolbox, and we'll see that in just a second. Toolbox drawer and drag the set background color block onto the start block on your workspace. Click next to move on to the next step in the tutorial. So the start button is already up here, so we don't need to do that. The scene is located right here. So you have sprites, controller, scene, info, loops, variables, math, and then advanced tools. So we want the scene to have a specific color. I'm going to drag this block You can drop it wherever you want to, but it's not going to work unless it's snapped into the start command. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to actually change that color. So we're going to change the color, and we want the background, I think a dark blue would be fine. And over here, you'll notice that the blue has changed. So it kind of gives you a snapshot or a highlight as to what your command is telling the actual game to do. Now, the next button is located right here. In the set background color block, so set background color block, click on the gray, which is what I already did. I jumped one step ahead. And in here, click the gray, open the color palette, select a background color, and I already did that. You'll notice just a second ago that clicking this will bring a hint up. So if you get stuck, it is absolutely okay to use this tutorial piece. I'm going to click next, open sprites inside the toolbox drawer, and drag out the first block. So set my sprite. So I have two of them. Set my sprite into the on start block on your workspace. This will create a new player. So I'm going to do this red one. And I'm going to set it right under here because it says into the on start block. So this will create a new player. So then I'm going to click next. So now it's time to draw your character by clicking on the gray square in the set my sprite block. So on this gray square, I'm going to click one time. And then this right here, it's your job to draw your character. So I wouldn't use a blue character on a blue background because it's not going to show up. So that would not be a good idea. I'm going to use the eraser and come through here and then undo all my work. Okay, and then I click back on the pencil. Maybe a contrast color would be black. And then this is going to be the character who's going to come through and then chase after the food. So this is where you get to use your creativity and then design a character. If you choose the Done button, then you'll have a chance to see what your character is going to look like on that background. And I failed to put color on that interior portion, so that means that the background is going to show up. And if you want to change your mind, then you can click one time, then you can come back in, and then you can add additional color to fill that in so that the dark blue background doesn't show up. All right, so now it says to open up the controller. So in the controller, I'm supposed to click this, and I'm supposed to set this inside after the set my sprite. And this is going to move your player around the screen. So try it out on the game simulator. So here I am using my mouse over here on these buttons on the game. And my sprite, my character, is moving with the buttons. I'm going to choose next. Open the sprites toolbox drawer and drag another set my sprite block into the on start block on your workspace. And this is going to be the pizza. So over here on sprites, I'm going to set my sprite number 2. And the computer has already recognized that I have a second character coming in. You'll notice right here that this one is different from this one. So my sprite versus my sprite number 2. In this space, this is where you're going to draw your food item. So if you want it to be an ice cream cone, then you can make an ice cream cone. If you want it to be pizza, it can be pizza. It is up to you what you would like. And done. So I have my food item. And they're sitting on top of one another. And so this is going to get remedied as we continue to move along. I'm going to choose next. This will be the pizza. Doesn't have to be pizza. I obviously chose ice cream. In the My Sprite 2 block, click on My Sprite 2 and select Rename Variable. So right here, I'm going to rename the variable. And it is okay if I choose ice cream. If you just want to type pizza because it says pizza on the screen and you're uncertain, that's totally okay. It doesn't matter. And then click OK and move on to the next. In the set pizza block, I chose ice cream, so we'll just call it the set pizza block. Click on the player kind and open the menu for a different kind. And we're going to select it as food. This is a food item. You'll notice how these instructions are walking you through step by step. I'm going to choose next. Click on the gray box for set pizza and then select gallery. So this is where you get to learn some new strategies. Up here in gallery, there are already tools that are ready to go. And so the gallery is another resource if you would like to use that. So not only do you have the power to make your own, but you can choose from the gallery instead. Open the Sprites toolbox drawer and drag the On Sprite Overlaps Other Sprite block onto your workspace, and it says you can put it anywhere. So Sprites is right here. So On Sprite of any kind overlaps another sprite of any kind. We're going to drag it in, and we will not set it inside. We're going to set it somewhere else. So we can scoot down if we need to. And next. I'm not going to read through the rest of these instructions for you. I'm going to give you an opportunity to troubleshoot, wrestle through, evaluate, and figure this out on your own. Go ahead and play that game. And then after you've had a chance to play that game, make some adjustments. See if you can make it better, make it more challenging, evaluate other strategies with inside this game. Team, thanks so much for paying attention to this tutorial, and I hope you enjoy using these resources and learning more about computer science. Have a great day, team.